Hello friends, in the last class we were discussing about the first chapter, that is knowing our numbers, and in that chapter we stopped at estimation of sum, that is in addition or subtraction. Now we will look at estimation of products. In the previous class, in the last class, I told you that to do any estimation, what we will do? We will take a approximate number. If the number is in tens, if the number is two digit number, then what we will do? We will approximate it to a nearest tens. If the number is three digit number, then we will approximate it to the nearest hundred. In the same way, it is for 1000 and 10,000 also. If the number is 4 digit and 5 digit, then what we will do? We will approximate the numbers to 1000 and 10,000 respectively. Okay. Now, we will look at estimation of product. Okay. And in the same way, suppose I'll take two digit numbers, that is 76 and 84. I want to find the product, that is I want to multiply these two numbers. Then what I will do? I will approximate these numbers to the nearest 10, that is nearest tens, that is 76. What we will do? See, this is 6, more than 5, so this number should be approximated to 80, and this 84, and it is less than 5, so we don't go to 90, we will take 80. So 80 into 80 is 1600. It is 6400. See, 8 are 64 and 2 zeros. Okay, now 18 into 8 is this much. Now let's check if these two numbers product is also approximate to this. That is 76 into 84. 4 6 are 24. 4 2 carry. 4 7 are 28. 28 plus 2 30. Plus 8 6 are 48, 8 and 4 carry, 8 7 are 56, 56 plus 4 60. This is 4, 0 plus 8 is 8, 3 plus 0 is 3, and 6 as it is. See, here we have got 6400. Here it is 6384. If we approximate these three numbers, it will be nearer to 400. So this number is approximately equal to this much. See, this is how to estimate. And this is about estimation in multiplication. Now, how to use brackets in multiplication? See, there is one example given in your textbook. That is, Meera bought 6 notebooks from the market and the cost was rupees 10 per notebook. Meera, a girl named Meera, got 6 notebooks. 6 notebooks at rupees 10 per book. That is, for one book it costed 10. And her sister Seema also got 7 notebooks of the same type. Seema bought 7 notebooks of the same type, that is same rupees 10 per book. Okay, now Mira will calculate the total amount to be paid. That is how she will calculate. Mira calculates it like this, that is 6 into 10 plus 7 into 10. This is for 6 notebooks. For 6 notebooks, Mira has to pay this much, and for 7 notebooks, Seema has to pay this much. So the total is 6 into 10 plus 7 into 10. This is 60 plus 70 is 130 rupees. This is 130 rupees. And Seema also calculates, but she calculates it in a different way. How she calculates? Seema first counts the number of books. Number of books is 6 plus 7, which is equal to 30, and the total cost will be 13 into 10 for each notebook. It is 130. See, 130 rupees. Both are same. Both the results are same. If you calculate it in this way, you will get one answer. If you calculate it in this way, you will get the same answer. So, from both these terms, what we can conclude is, see here, 10 is common here. Here also it is 10, and here also it is 10. So, what we can do? We can take 10 common, that is, first 6. In this, if I take 10 common, it is 6 plus 7 into 10. See, if I multiply, what I will do? I will multiply 10 with 6 and then I will multiply 7 also. Okay, so this is how to write bracket. See, I'll keep it here. With the method I have told you, if I give you a number with a bracket, you must be able to multiply it. Okay, keep it in mind. We will multiply this with this first, and we will multiply this with the second term. Okay, both this will be same. Okay, now if I give you a number like 5, 6 into 13 plus 2. See, this is bracket, this is multiplication, this is same. Okay, now what is the method? First multiply the 6 with the first number, and then multiply 6 with the second number and add those. 6 into 13, so it is 6 into 13 plus 6 into 2. See, here what we did, 10 is common, so we have taken it outside the bracket, and we wrote it as common. Here 6 is common, so in the reverse way we can multiply it. Okay, now 6 into 13, 6 is 24, sorry, 6 is 18, 8, 130, and 6 is 6 plus 7, 78. So 6 into 13 is 78 plus 6 into 2 is 12. This is how much? 90. Okay, this is by multiplying 6 to both the numbers. Or else we will do second method. What is this? What is the second method? 13 plus 2 is 15. So it will be 6 into 15. Why 15? See, 13 plus 2 is 15 and into 6. What is 6 into 15? 15 into 6. 6 5 is 30. 0, 3, 3, 6, 1, 2, 6, plus 3, 90. See, both the same. Either if we add the terms in the bracket first and multiply, or we will multiply the common term to both the terms in the bracket and we will add later on. Both will be same. So, this is how to multiply the numbers given in bracket. Okay. In the last class, I told you something like, you may be wondering why 6 is written like this. I told you this, right? Now I will tell you why 6 is written like this. In the ancient time, what used to happen is, in this you will also get to know the importance of 0. Okay? In the ancient time, the Roman people, that is in the Roman Empire, that is in Italy, in present Italy, the number system was like this. They used symbols to represent numbers. What are those symbols? They are, for one, they used something like this. Okay? And for 5, they used a symbol like this. For 10, they used a symbol like this. And this goes on, like for 50, they used L. For 100, they used C. For 500, they used D. And for 1000, they used M. See, these are the symbols they have used to represent the numbers. And let us see how the numbers are written continuously, that is in series, like 1, 2, 3, 4 and like this. That is, it goes on in this way. 1 is with the single line like I, and 2 is like this, 3 with 3 lines, 4, 1 before this B, I before B, or 5 is represented by B, 6 with B and 1 or I, 7 with B and 2 I's, 8 with B and then 3 I's, 9 with 1 or I before X, and 10 as X. How is this written? With these symbols, the Roman people, they made some rules. Okay? They made some rules. What are those rules are? Wait. Okay. So, what are the rules? The rules are, first rule is, if a symbol is repeated, its value is added as many times as it occurs. See, if a symbol is repeated, see here, 1, 2, 3, this 1 is repeated how many times? It is repeated for 3 times. So its value is added, which means this is 3 and there are 3 ones. So 1 plus 1 plus 1. If the symbols are repeated, its value is added as many times as it is represented, as it is repeated. See, here it is 3 times repeated, so its value is added 3 times. 1 plus 1 plus 1 will be 3. And here it is repeated 2 times, so its value is added as many times as it is repeated. Here it is added for, here it is repeated for 2 times, so its value will be added 2 times. 1 plus 1. And you know 1 plus 1 is 2, right? And the second rule is, a symbol is not repeated more than 3 times. Clear? This symbol I or 1 is repeated only for 3 times, not more than 3 times. Anywhere in the Roman numbers, a symbol is repeated. See here, only if a symbol is repeated, it is only for maximum 3 times, not more than 3 times. Here at least I have used this 1 for 3 times, and the next number I did not use it for 4 times. I used some other symbol. Okay, so this is what the second rule is. The third rule is, if a symbol of smaller value is returned to the right of the symbol of greater value, its value gets added to the value of greater symbol. For example, 6. If a symbol of smaller value, that is here it contains smaller value symbol, is in these two symbols, it has in the total this thing, the total representation, it has got two symbols. One is V, one is I. Okay, see here, this one is smaller value, this one is greater value. Okay, this is smaller value number, this is greater value number. And the rule 3 is, if a smaller value symbol is written on the right side of a greater value, see here, it is, this is my left and this is right, so smaller value number symbol is written to the right side of a greater value symbol, then its value get added to the greater value symbol. That is, here in this representation, this one is added to this, that is, this has got a value 5 and this is plus 1, which is equal to 6. And in 7, there are smaller value symbols repeated 2 times, and it is on the right side of a greater value number. So 5 plus the first rule is, if a symbol is repeated, has been repeated, then it should be added as many times as it is repeated. Then it is 1 plus 1. Why I am adding? They are on the right side, which is the third rule. So 5 plus 1 plus 1 is 7. Okay, this is rule 3. And rule 4, if a symbol of smaller value is written on the left of a symbol of greater value, its value is subtracted from the value of greater symbol. Example 4 and 9. See here, in 4, there are two symbols, I and V. V has got value 5, I has got value 1. And rule 4 is, if a smaller value symbol is written on the left side of a greater value symbol, then its value must be subtracted from the greater value symbol. See here, from for to represent 4, what I am doing, I am writing this I before 5, before V. So if it is written on the left side, its value must be reduced or subtracted. Its value must be subtracted from the greater value number, 5 minus 1. And see here, till here I have written what the same symbols in a repeated way. And in fourth symbol, what I am doing, I am not using the same symbol 4 times, because it is first rule that any symbol should not be repeated for more than 3 times. Okay, this is about rule 1, 2, 3, 4. And what is rule 5? The symbols V, L, D are never written to the left of a symbol of greater value. See here, these symbols V, L and D, they are never written on the left side of the greater value number, because till then we can use on the right side only these values, like I, 10, this C and M. For example, see what rule 5 says is, for 11, what we will do, for this symbol I can write a smaller valued symbol on the right side and I can make it 11 like this is 10, and if I write 1 on the right side it will be 11, because if a smaller value number is written on the right side it is, its value gets added to it. So this is, and this is root 3, so it is 11. But what we can do is we can write it in a different way, like 20 suppose is represented by this symbol, that is this is 10 plus 10, this will be 20. From 20, if I use smaller digit numbers on the left side, its value get decreased. Like if, then what I can do? I can write this 11 in this way. This is 20 and minus 9. For minus 9, what I have to do? I will write a smaller value number this side, and for minus 4, I will write this side. See, this becomes more complex. That is why root 5 says is a smaller value symbols like V, L, and D are not written on the left side of a greater value symbol. This is your rule 5. Okay, so these are the rules to write numbers in Roman number system. Okay, I told you that with this you will get to know the importance of zero. How? See, if I take a number like 80, how is 80 written? Recall that 50 is given symbol L and 10 is given symbol X. Then what will be the Roman number for 80? It will be L and X and X and X. That is 50 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. 50 plus 10 is 60, 60 plus 10 is 70, 70 plus 10 is 80. See how the number becomes. That is why this system, decimal number system, which has got a zero in it, which is introduced by the Indians, has a very great value. Okay, so this is all about your first chapter, that is knowing our numbers. Thank you.